Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to explore what is premium per user licensing. When you are started working in Power BI, and you may aware like there are different licensing options like Pro license and Premium license. And till this point of time, there is no premium per user license. There is Pro and Premium, where Pro is per user licensing and Premium is per capacity. And a lot of users, those who want to use premium features, like they cannot afford that particular licensing cost. So based on this request and to compensate the premium features, the Power BI team has come up with a new licensing term called premium per users. That is what we are going to see in deep in this video. What is the superpower you will get when you have a premium per user? Let us check it out in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to get the updates related to Power BI. Let's begin. What is premium per user? So it is a new way of license premium features on per user basis. It includes all Power BI Pro license capabilities, along with features like paginated reports, AI, and other capabilities only available in premium today. Meaning like when you have a Power BI, premium per user license, you will use paginated reports and AI other capabilities. Those are only meant for premium user licensing. So earlier, those who have a premium capacity, which is too much costly, that a small and medium organizations cannot afford that cost, but still they want to use these capabilities. They cannot do it because of the licensing cost. Now, the premium per user licensing introduction, the small and medium enterprises can benefit from this license. That is the core logic behind that. So a lot of questions mostly like if the premium per user license is available, the user no need to have a pro license. So let us try to check the pricing in next slides and in a couple of minutes. So the point is like the pro is the one level below your premium. Premium is always, as the name indicates, one level above your pro licensing. So once you have a premium license, you will get all the powers you have in pro along with the premium capabilities. So you no need to have pro licensing again. And this is typically developed, this licensing part is introduced by Microsoft to help the small and medium enterprises who is having around 10 to 200. I cannot say the numbers exactly because it's based on what capabilities they are using, right? So it is to help very limited persons is going to use these features, but they cannot afford the premium price. So in considering this business in mind, so Power BI team has introduced this license. That is the main logic behind this. Let us try to compare the different features between premium. So in premium licensing, you have earlier you have only per capacity, like when you buy a premium, you will get 400 GB, 48 refresh rates, all the functionalities of premium. So now, what is the core difference between per capacity and per user? So per user, you will not get these support like multi-geo support, unlimited distribution, Power BI on-premise. Once you buy a Power BI premium capacity, the on-premise service is also free. It is a complimentary, whether you can deploy all your reports in the premium, like all the features you can use. Along with that, you can also have your Power BI on-premise service as well. This is one of the feature that you will get it in Power BI per capacity. But when it comes to Power BI per user, you will not get this option. That is the core difference. But other things is fine because this is meant for small and medium business. So 100 GB is fine compared to the capacity. But the core logic most of them want to understand is like, what is the difference between pro and premium per user? Let us try to check that one. So futures you avail with Power BI per user compared with pro. It is not only this, whatever futures you avail with pro, along with that, you will get this extra, these features not available for the pro users. That is paginated reports, advanced AI, data flows, and application lifecycle management. So basically, like, I'm going to cover all these topics in a separate video, like when you have a Power BI premium per user, how advanced AI features can be used, data flows with direct query, linked data flows, and application lifecycle management. Then the Power BI paginated reports is a separate playlist. I will cover it in detail in a separate playlist. Earlier it was called as SSRS, still it is available. So now the futures, these are the futures, and the costing wise, let us try to go to the Microsoft website. So now you can see this is the costing details, whereas Power BI Pro license is $10 and whereas Power BI premium per user is $20. And you can see there is a huge cost in Power BI per capacity, which is around $5,000. This cannot be affordable by a small and medium enterprise. Assume like they need 10 to 20 premium per user, and they are, 10 to 20 means it's around $200 to $400. Instead of paying $200, $400, if they want to use a premium capacity, then they might have spent $5,000. It's a huge saving for a small and medium enterprises. This is the logic behind this. I really appreciate that Power BI has come up with this plan. It is going to be a game changer. And so these are the different plans: Power BI Pro, Power BI Premium, Power BI Premium per capacity. So Pro and Premium, we forgot about this, as this is meant for those who want going for Pro and using a premium capacity. So you can see here the basic difference here between Pro and Premium is paginated reports. Those who are not familiar with paginated reports, I will definitely cover a separate playlist for paginated reports. When it comes to data prep and modeling visualization, the key difference over here is like advanced AI and XML endpoint, data flows. So data flows is part of Pro license as well, but here specifically they mentioned direct query, linked data flows. Like you created a data flow, and that data flow can be referred in another data flow. Those features available only for the premium capacity. Along with that, you can analyze the data in Azure Data Lakes. Finally, the application lifecycle management. This is another one of my favorite. Then the maximum storage is 100 TB, right? So you can store this much amount of storage. So these are the powers you will get, and we will try to explore more about Power BI per user licensing in our upcoming videos. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.